The next question here we have is the prove the following grammar is ambiguous. Okay, in order to prove this grammar to be ambiguous, you need to take one statement and show that you could be able to generate two parse trees using this grammar. Then you can say that this grammar is ambiguous. So how you can do that? I'll take one example here to show you the same. Grammar given here is S derives to be A. The statement derives to be A. It's of course kind of assignment statement only. Assignment is derives to be A plus A or ID. Okay, and then you have ID derives defines to be A or B or C. So I have to prove this grammar to be ambiguous. How can I prove that grammar is ambiguous? When I can able to construct two parse trees for the single statement using that grammar. I will take one statement here. Let us take one statement A plus B plus C. Okay, A plus B plus C is my statement. Now, here you can see this grammar is a recursive grammar. Why you say the grammar is recursive? When you find LHS part, this is the LHS part. LHS part is available on the RHS. So fine, RHS. So you can say it is a recursive, but it is a two-way recursive. Why? You can find that LHS is available on both LHS and RHS of the operation. Yes or no? So this is said to be the two-way recursion, right? So these kind of grammars can be derived using either leftmost or rightmost. It means I can go with leftmost derivation. I can construct one parse tree for the same statement using this grammar with leftmost derivation. And another one is rightmost derivation. Okay. Rightmost derivation. Now let us check A plus B plus C. So the statement here is defines to be A. Then A, which definition I should take in order to get A plus B plus C? I have two definitions for A. A plus A or ID. So I'll go with A plus A, right? So left child is A and the middle child is plus, okay? Then I have, then here I could find A plus A, right? So what should I take in place of A? What kind of definition should I take? I'll take ID and then say A here, A, B, C, anyway I have, so I'll take A here. So now this A, I am further expanding it with A plus A, right? Okay, so then this A, I can derive it with ID, and ID can be derived with B because I need to get A plus B plus C, right? So by expanding the right recursion rather, right? Then I say it is a leftmost derivation. So in leftmost derivation, you will find the terminals to be available from left to right. Okay, so you can see here this grammar, this particular statement to be derived using this grammar using leftmost derivation. Then leftmost derivation in the sense right recursive. See, when I use this particular expression to be expanded, okay, this particular recursion to be expanded, then I say because that's on the right, right? So if I consider this as the right, recursion and then expand it, then I will get the leftmost derivation rather, right? If I take left recursion to be expanded, okay, and then I generate the tree, then I say it is the rightmost derivation, okay? So here, in order to derive this particular statement A plus B plus C, I started with the statement S and then I have derived it to be A. And then this A can be derived with two definitions, right? We have two definitions here. A defines to be A plus A, or ID rather, right? So out of these two definitions, I will take the first definition. Okay, so A plus A, left child is A, and the middle child is plus, and then right child is A. You know, the identifiers, you know, enclosed in tags are said to be the non-terminals, right? So this non-terminal is can be further derived to be again either A plus A or ID. But in order to get this particular statement, I need to take a second definition for this, right? So I have taken the second definition for A here, that is ID, and then ID here is defined to be either A or B or C. So out of this, any one of this I can take, but in order to get this particular statement to be derived, I will take A. Okay, so I have taken A here, right? Then on the right hand side, the A to be expanded, I am going with the first definition, right, in order to get B plus C on the right hand side. So A is now derived to be A plus A with the first definition. Then I need to substitute from left onwards rather, right? So I am now substituting A with ID, second definition, and then ID will be substituted with B in order to get B here rather, right? A plus B. And then this A, in order to get C here, I need to derive it with ID and then further derive it to with C. So then you can see a tree is constructed. This particular tree is said to be the parse tree, but this has been derived using the leftmost derivation. Another point, leftmost derivation by expanding the right recursion, right? By expanding the right recursion. But I can construct another parse tree for the same statement, okay, using this particular grammar, right? By expanding the left recursion. I will show you that one as well. You can see here, S is a statement derived to be A here, okay? Then this A to be derived with the first definition, A plus A, right? Now what is that I'm doing? I'm expanding the left recursion, and right will be terminated with the terminal. So here, what I'm doing is the right, you know, side. When do you say rightmost derivation? When the terminals you are able to get from the right to left rather, right? So this A is derived to be ID and then derived to be further C. Then this A, I am deriving it with the first definition again, A plus A. Another point. Now, this A will be further derived to B with second definition ID, and then since I have to get A plus B plus C, ID will be substituted with A. Then here on the right hand side, A will be now derived to B ID with the second definition. In order to get A plus B plus C, this has to be substituted with B. So you can see now you got A plus B plus C. Okay, you got the same statement being derived. But you can see the parse trees are different, right? This is one parse tree with leftmost derivation. This is another parse tree with rightmost derivation, right? You can see the structure of the parse trees are different, right? Compiler is going to identify the statements with the help of parse trees. But if the parse tree structure is different, then compiler will be in an ambiguity, right? It will be in a doubt to take which one to carry out for the execution rather, right? So if the grammar is of this kind, then we say it is an ambiguous grammar, right? So these kind of grammars, right, are not recommended, fine. So in order to make this grammar from ambiguous to unambiguous, what we have to do, we have to replace one of the recursion, that is left or right recursion. You can either replace left recursion with another term instead of having the same as that of the LHS part, or you can replace right recursion with the another term, right? So it could be just ID, or can be some kind of term, right? So instead of having the LHS part, when you have the LHS part, you see this is LHS. When the LHS part is available on both LHS and RHS of the operation, then the grammar leads to ambiguous, right? So here in this question, what he said is to prove the following grammar is ambiguous. Only thing what you have to do is you have to construct two parse trees using leftmost derivation and rightmost derivation, and say that when a particular statement can be derived with more than one parse tree using the same grammar, then that grammar is said to be ambiguous. That is what you have to say. That's it. Okay. I think I hope this is clear to all of you. Shall I move? Let us go on to the next statement. Compute the weakest precondition for each of the following statement and postcondition. So let us check this. A equal to 2 into b minus 1 minus 1, where a greater than 0, right? What is the weakest precondition for this particular statement? Weakest precondition, when do you say weakest precondition? The least restricted value for b, which will satisfy the postcondition. Postcondition must be what? A greater than 0. A greater than 0 means what? It can be 1, 2, 3 and all, if it is integer. Okay. Fine. So in that case, I'll take b value as 2. Shall I take b value 2 here? Then what happens? A becomes 2 into b minus 1 means 2 minus 1 minus 1. 2 minus 1 is 1. 2 into 1 minus 1. 2 minus 1 is nothing but 1, which is greater than 0. So it is satisfying. So I can say here b equal to 2 is the precondition, weakest precondition, if I consider integers. Okay, no rational values. Got the point? If I consider only integers, here that condition is not given, but you can probably assume it rather, right? If you take rational values, then it is very difficult rather, right? Consider it as integers. If I consider it as integers, then what happens? The weakest precondition will be b equal to 2. If I take b equal to 2, I'm getting a value as 1, which is greater than 0, satisfying the post condition. What is the post condition here? A greater than 0 being satisfied when b equal to 0. So this is the precondition and this is the post condition, right? So I think it is clear. This is how you're going to calculate. Similarly, for the subsequent statements also you can calculate. In order to make this grammar from ambiguous to unambiguous, how can you do that? You can use any one of the recursion, left recursion or right recursion. So if I take right recursion, then probably here I need to take another variable, right? Term plus I have to substitute this A. I have LHS part available on both LHS and RHS of the operation, right? One of them I have to replace it with some another term. Got the point? So I have replaced the left recursion with term here, let us say. And then term is going to be defined further. What's the point? So term here is going to be defined. And I say here, I'll give another definition for the same like term also. Then term is defined to be ID. And ID is defined to be A, capital A, B, C. I have changed this grammar from ambiguous to unambiguous, right? So how do you change, this kind of questions also may be asked. You will be given an ambiguous grammar and asked to convert it into unambiguous. This I am saying unambiguous. Why? I could be able to generate only one parse tree. If you are able to generate a unique parse tree, a single parse tree for any given statement using the grammar, then that grammar is said to be unambiguous, right? What I have done is I have replaced one of the recursion. I have, in this statement, you have both left and right recursion, right? I have replaced left recursion with term. Got the point? And this A, I have given another definition for A is as term also. So there are two definitions for A, term plus A or term. And then this term is further defined with ID, and ID is defined with ABC. Now use this grammar, okay? Now use this unambiguous grammar and derive this particular statement. Then you see how many trees you are going to generate, only single tree rather, right? So I'll take this grammar now. I have, let us say, B plus C plus A, okay? So how I am able to derive this, statement using this grammar, you can see here S is derives to be A, A is derives to be term plus A, then here this can be derives to be ID, and then further derives to be B, okay? And then this A will be defined to be, with the first definition, term plus, and let us say A. And this term will be further defined to be ID, and then C. And this will be derived to be term, then further derived to be ID, then A. Okay, you got this statement, B plus C plus A. Can you be able to construct another parse tree using this grammar for this statement? Is it possible? No, okay. Because here you have the right recursion. So right recursion will be expanded. So, and you are getting, when you are, this kind of grammar is said to be right recursive grammar. And I have used leftmost derivation. You can see the terminals, I got it from the left to right onwards, right? Other point, I hope now, I think how to convert ambiguous to unambiguous is also clear, right? What you have to do is you have to replace one of the recursion, okay, with another term, either left or right recursion. If I replace the left recursion with another term, then that grammar becomes right recursion. Okay. If I am replacing right recursion with some another term, then that grammar becomes left recursion, left recursive grammar. So left recursive grammars are derived through rightmost derivation. Right recursive grammars are derived through leftmost derivation. These are the fundamentals. Okay. That have to be followed. Now coming to 11th question, convert the following expression into prefix and postfix. What is the statement given? A plus B minus C into D by E minus F plus. See, while converting the expressions, you need to keep two things in mind, as I've discussed in the operation chapter, right? First thing is how many operators you have and what is the precedence of the operators you have set for it, right? You will have to take the precedence. The language designer will set the precedence for the operators. Precedence is nothing but the priority, the order in which the operators have to be executed when you have the multiple operations in the single statement. You can see here you have plus into minus in, divide parenthesis. So I will here set the precedence of these operators starting with, let us say, parenthesis one are having the higher precedence. What's the point? So parenthesis will be evaluated first, I am saying. Then I say into and divide. Into and divide will be the next to be evaluated, but having the equal precedence. Okay, equal precedence. Then I will be setting as plus and minus to be evaluated next to into divide, but then having the equal precedence. Got the point? Now I have this statement, right? A plus B minus C into divide by, within parenthesis, I have E minus F plus G. Got the point? Okay. Now, you can see you have parenthesis expression, you have into, you have divide, you have plus and minus. But as per the precedence rule, I need to evaluate the higher precedence one, which is nothing but parenthesis, which is nothing but E minus F. So this one is going to be evaluated first, okay? E minus F has to be evaluated first. So I am writing stepwise in order to make you more clear, so that if any such big expression is given, you can just follow this steps blindly. That will definitely give you the correct answer. Okay, let us say step one. Okay, I say this is step one. Okay, so in this step one, what is it I'm evaluating? I'm evaluating, let us say, minus in parenthesis. Okay, so if I have to convert this particular, just take the sub expression, I'm taking small, right? This whole expression is my infix now. I have to convert this into prefix, okay? So prefix equivalent. How do you convert infix into prefix? Operator will be first. So operator is minus, so first operator, then followed by, you have the operands. In pre means first, no, post means after. So if operator is represented first, you say it is prefix. So first operator, then followed by, you have operands E and F. This is step one. The next operation to be evaluated in this particular expression is what? Here you have multiplication and division, both having the equal precedence. When you have equal precedence operators in the same expression, you go with associativity rule. And here, if associativity rule also is not given, you go with left associativity, okay, for all, except the exponential, as I mentioned while I was discussing. Okay, most of the language designers will take left associativity rule for all the expressions, for all the operations, except the exponential. For exponential, right associativity should be taken. Okay, this is the fundamental rule. Okay, every language designer will follow. Fine. So what do you mean by left associativity rule? When you have the multiple operator with the equal precedence, you need to evaluate it from the left to right. So we have into and divide having the equal precedence. I should take which one is coming first from the left, which is nothing but into. So C into D. I consider this as part two. Okay. I consider this as part two. So in part two, I'm evaluating what? Into. So how do I write? Just consider only this expression as an infix. Now I have to convert this into prefix. How do I do that? First, you write the operator into, then followed by operands. What are the operands? C and D. Got it right. So this is part two. Now the next operation to be evaluated is in divide rather, right? So this divide is going to be performed on one and two. Two is the left operand for this, because after being evaluated, what it becomes a value. After this, when evaluated, you get a value here, rather, right? So this becomes an operand, left operand for the division, and this becomes part one becomes the right operand for division. So the next operator to be evaluated, I'm considering in the next step, that is divide. So I'm considering this as the part three. So in part three, where I'm representing, I'm considering this whole as an expression, infix expression. Now, in order to convert this into prefix, I say operator first. What is the operator? By. And what is the left operand here? Part two. The entire part two I need to write. Okay. Entire part two. This whole become a value rather, right? So I just represent as it is. Then what is the right operand? Right operand is a part one. What is a part one? Minus EF. Got it. Now this whole become a value after being evaluated. Now what is the next operator to be evaluated? You have plus, minus, and again plus. All again equal precedence. So again, you go with left associativity rule, right? So which one going to be evaluated first? Plus, obviously. So this becomes the next operation to be evaluated. I am considering it as part four. So part four, in part four, the plus is going to be evaluated. So how do I write first operator? Then I write the operands A and B. Okay, left operand is A, right operand is B. Okay, this has now become a value. Now, what is the next operation to be carried out? Minus, obviously.
Sir, right? There's part. Another plus at the end, no sir, plus G.
Yeah, but then you have minus and plus having the equal precedence, right? Equal
precedence. First you have to go left, right? So you have to do minus first.
Yes, you then when you have the equal precedence, you go with left associativity. So minus plus, since both are equal and minus is coming first, so you go with minus here, right? So, and this minus operation is going to be evaluated on whom? The left operand is four, right? First you write the operator, then you write the left operand. What is the left operand? The entire four. Entire four is nothing but plus AB. Plus AB. What the point? Then the right operand. What is the right operand here? The entire three. What is that three? This one, right? By into CD minus EF. What the point? So this whole has now become part five. This whole has become part five. And only operator left out is the plus. So that you are doing it in part six. So in part six, the leftover operator is plus to be now converted into prefix. So while you are doing, you first write the operator, then you write the left operand. What is the left operand? The entire part five is the left operand for this plus. What is part five here? Minus plus AB by into CD minus EF. This whole has become the left operand for plus. What is the right operand? That is G. Okay, so this is your prefix equivalent infix expression. What the point? So if you go like this step wise, you can solve for any big expression. What the point? So for This is the given expression. Now I am asked to convert this into postfix. I'll follow the same rules, right? Precedence rules are same and associativity rules also same, right? Which we have said, right? So now while I am converting this, what do I do? I'll first go with the first operation. What is the first operation here to be evaluated as per the precedence? Yes, parenthesis. So E minus F, I'm considering that as the part one, parenthesis minus. So how do I convert this infix into postfix? I'll write the operands first. What is the operand here? Left operand is E, right operand is F. Then you have the operator is minus. So in postfix, you write the operands first and then you write the operator. When you write operator next or last, I say it is post. If the operator is written first, I say it is pre. Okay. So now this whole has become part one, which now becomes a value or an operand. Now what is the next operator to be evaluated is obviously into, right? You have into divide with the next precedence, but then both are equal and into is coming first as per the associativity, left associativity. I need to carry out into first. So we will be then evaluating into. So how do you evaluate this into or convert this into a postfix? Is left operand C, right operand D, then you write the operator, that is into. So this has become part two. Now the next operator to be evaluated is by, obviously, right? By that I'm considering in part three. So in part three, I'm converting division operation. So while converting, what do? You first write the left operand. What is the left operand here? The entire two is the left operand. Got it? CD into. CD into. Then you write the right operand. What is the right operand? Part one. What is it? EF minus. Got it? Then what is the operator? Operator is by. Okay, so this whole has become a value now, part three. The next operator to be evaluated is plus, obviously, because you have leftover operators are plus, minus, plus. All are having equal precedence. And then you go with left associativity. It means you will be evaluating the plus, right? So part four, I consider this as part four. So here, plus will be evaluated. So I'm when converting this into postfix, how do I write left operand A and right operand B? Then I write the operator A, B plus. Okay, this whole has become a value now. The next operator to be evaluated is obviously minus here. And minus, for minus, what is the left operand? Part four, that is A, B plus. And then for this minus, right operand is two. What is two here? C, D in two. C, D in two. Then I write the operator minus. Then in part six, okay, this whole has become, sorry, I need to write the entire part three here in minus. For minus, what is the left operand? Left operand is four and right operand is part three, entire part three rather, right? So what is part three here? Part three is C D into E F minus Y. Then I will be writing the operator, that is minus. Got it? So this whole has become part five now. Okay, this whole has become part five. Now the leftover operator is only plus. So that I am, you know, converting it in next step, that is six. So in six, for plus operator, what is the left operand? You write the first left operand, then write right operand followed by the operator. Left operand is entire part five. What is entire part five? That is A, B plus C, D into E, F minus by minus. Then you write the right operand. What is the right operand? G. Then what is the operator? That is plus. So this is your postfix equivalent of this given infix expression. I hope it is clear for all of you, right? So similarly, you can do it for the next expression also. If you go like this stepwise, okay, you never mistake it. Okay, your answer will be obviously correct. And before doing that, you need to set the precedence rule. If the precedence rules are given, that's well and good. Otherwise, you set the precedence rules.